Fresh. Now I've been in New York, Texas, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A, D-M-V, all reminds me of California.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we should look to the war up front. The Falcons are top 10 in rushing yards, going up against the Niners front seven that will need to be up to the test. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, and what is scheduled to be its final season as an NFL stadium, there's a look at the Georgia Dome here in Atlanta. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the San Francisco 49ers and the Atlanta Falcons. This will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here on first down, firing quickly here, and that's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And now we'll get a stoppage here. There appears to be an injured Falcon on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Fresh set of downs here.
Hurry up, here we go. Green.
They'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Try again with the arm here on second down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by David Anderson. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Hurry up, here we go.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain, and it's second down. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. 10 yards still left on second down.
Here we go now. Green.
He'll drop to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Yardage here, back at the 47. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Here we go now.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Partner, your thoughts on this D-line.
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. They'll set up a throw, and he comes back with one complete. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. And here's a very low line drive, almost whipped on it. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Hurry up, here we go.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Going to throw right side here. Complete. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
Here we go now. 3-19.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost. Taking it right down Broadway. And this is going to be brought back. It's a scoop and score for the Falcon TD. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice to such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And a cut to the sideline. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, 49ers. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And his kick is right through. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field, and they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. That one goes for 24 yards.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Now, Barney, 40. All right, here we go.
look to throw here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Eli Harold in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. Back to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
And that drop will cause a little bit of angst for the play caller because you know they've worked all week game planning and flexing the tight end out and making him a matchup issue.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Now back to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. His throw incomplete. And here now the defensive starters for Atlanta.
Vic Beasley's a very talented outside linebacker whose number one task, rush the passer. But he has the athletic ability to drop into coverage.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
Let's go!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 18 yards there and a first down.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Back to throw here. Forced out to his left. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And now a first down following that long gain. To throw again. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Again, he'll drop to throw. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Carl Nassib in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. And that's off the right upright, and it bounces away, no good. And in this first quarter play, this will remain a tie ball game. So distance, not the issue there. He had plenty of leg to get it there. It's that darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the end of the football. No such luck there for him.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. And they'll run it here. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
2 plays in a row, the defense won, stacking up the running game. They've got to feel good about themselves, but something has to be in the back of their minds. Are we being set up for something big? They've got to be careful.
An extra DB for the 49ers now on 3rd. He'll look to throw. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fellow runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
On 3rd and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
this
time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Second down following the incompletion. They're going to look to throw. He's going to let it go again. And that's caught inside the 30. That goes for a gain of 31.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
Back to throw now on first down. His throw caught at about the 5. 22 yards of the pickup there. And the 49ers are set up now with a first and goal. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's caught at the one. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Looks to punch it in here from the one on second and goal. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. He lost two there. And it's third down.
And that loss of yards there is not just on him. It's on the guys blocking for him. I mean, they're supposed to create some type of space or at least get a stalemate. End up letting them through. And ended up tackling him for a loss.
The ground they go with a running back and across the goal line into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. A great play there with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season, and he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game, and the 49ers add on to their lead. Now Brenza will boom it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll drop the throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game.
So he rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
A gain of 3, second down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. So a pause here for us as well. Time to pay some bills. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Seven yards to go on second down. Back to throw here. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Third and 4. He'll drop to throw. And it's complete. Hooper. They give him 12 yards and a first down.
and fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. And he's got it up and through. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Let's go!
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throwing right, and that's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You drop an eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Let's go!
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
So a ways to go here on third and 10. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to air one out. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
Well, the obvious goal is to try and score a touchdown, but at the least, adding to a pretty big yardage total for his intended receiver there, huh?
Yeah, well, when you've got a guy over 150 yards, keep chucking it deep to him, I guess.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can get it to him short, and he can make plays that way, but I like what you just said. Throw it to him deep and get it a big chunk.
But incomplete on that try. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And where the ball is now, you got the field goal pretty much in the bag. Now do you try for the end zone a couple of times?
I don't think there's any question about it. You might get a gift of 6 points rather than the three that you just noted that you feel like you already have.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So third down, and the Falcons going with a dime. Six defensive backs. He'll look to throw. He's got time. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
They'll throw now on the final play. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to take another. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. So we've hit halftime all even at 14 apiece. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changes you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And while that play was unsuccessful to start the second half, I'm not sure that you just totally abandon what you do running the football. Maybe you make some adjustments in your run game and do things a little bit differently, but that doesn't necessarily mean you just go to the pass and do nothing else.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slant. That catch good for five. It's third down.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. They'll come out in the pistol. Looking to throw. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. So he makes the grab, and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. The tackle there by Eli Harrell.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Flushed out right. And he's got some space here. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
So they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. Calling a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Again, we'll see the pistol here. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Here we go now.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect better.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third.
All right, here we go.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And an alley to run. First possession of the 3rd quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, ah, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on 1st down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on 1st down.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on 3rd. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
And that's not a call you see every day. The toss play inside their own 10-yard line. Takes a little bit of brass right there, and they were able to get a little bit of yardage.
They'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a 3rd down. They tried to swing it out left into the flat, but the defense, they were very principled there.
It felt very West Coast offense, didn't it? You know their expression, right? On a West Coast offense, when they throw the ball, it's either going to be a touchdown or a check down, meaning they like to press it downfield. If they don't have it, swing it out, which is exactly what we saw there. But how about the great pursuit and tackle to make a nice play?
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Back to throw here. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
Let's take it inside his own 40. Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position, and he just gets taken out.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. They'll run it here. This is their fullback getting the carry. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Good solid gain on 1st down, about what you'd expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And quick throw here, that's complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside.
Third down and three. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Back now here on EA Sports. All square, 14 apiece to score as we get ready for the fourth quarter. Offense walks to the line for play number seven of the drive. They'll look to throw here. And he rifles one incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
Now play number eight on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third.
Here we go now. Move now.
He'll look to throw. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it, and now fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now, as he's on to punt for Atlanta. This is taken at the 15. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now the 49er offense ready to go and getting back out onto the field. And they got across the 50 last time but fumbled and turned it over, so they'll be looking to have a short-term memory here, Mr. Davis.
Not only a short-term memory, but a whole lot better ball security. Because if they take care of the ball, continue to move it, their chances of scoring some points, they got to feel pretty good about. They thought they had things moving in the right direction last time. Fumbles, they don't just affect you on offense. They affect your overall team because now your defense has to make that stand up.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by David Anderson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Falcons now making their way back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
That's a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Second down following the run. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
That play almost seemed like a baseball play. See ball, hit ball. But in this case, see guy with ball, tackle guy with ball.
Third down and four. They'll drop to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. And the defense coming through on third down. A loss of seven to bring up fourth. Here's Matt Bosher now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one goes angling out of bounds, and it will be spotted inside the 30-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. 18 yards on the pickup there. And the 49ers are going to get a first. Complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and five. A play fake as they set up to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
First down, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete here.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Game here. Time starting to run down. The defense really needs to try and keep this game tied. See if they can get the ball back for the offense. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this.
Here we go. Green, 39.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the 49ers have moved out in front.
Mm-hmm.
Now Brenza will boom it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Yeah, here now come the Falcons. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance. Because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something bad to be gained from it.
Back to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And they're going to speed things up here. He's back to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defender's going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw it to him. And that was a play made by the defense, and it could have been a bigger one.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Back to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And with the big gain, they'll go ahead and decline the penalty. Throw now on first down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by David Amerson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts.
Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. He'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And, oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose.
It's not often that we see big plays end in disaster. We just absolutely saw it right there. they had something really big cooking on that one.
Can you, when you're down near the goal line like that on a big play, do you get maybe a little too careless, a little too desperate for the goal line?
I think the last part is exactly right. You get desperate for the goal line, and sometimes you get the ball out of hip, away from your body, or you're trying to extend to get there, or maybe you're just trying so hard that the ball will come out of your hands. In any event, that's a big opportunity lost.
They'll look to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Give him credit for batting it away, but unable to come up with the interception, and sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but a lot of credit on that play for just knocking it away.
Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Sometimes it looks pretty simple, batting the ball away, but oftentimes there's some pretty good teaching and practice that goes into it. Being able to get to the receiver, not interfere, and get his hands through the football and knock it away.
And they'll send the slot in motion left. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up.